Bun găsit, dragi prieteni! Doi muzicieni de pe două continente s-au întâlnit printr-o întâmplare măruntă aparent, dar foarte fericită și au reușit să creeze un continent în care încăpem cu toții, un continent care înseamnă, de fapt, un album muzical, o primă parte dintr-o trilogie la care lucrează invitații noștri Stacy Walker din America și Cornel Olar de aici, din România. Cum s-a întâmplat să se întâlnească și ce înseamnă acest continent întreg pe care ni-l oferă o primă parte dintr-o trilogie muzicală, aflăm în această întâlnire în care vă invităm să ne însoțiți. Hi, Stacy and Cornel. We are going to speak in English and it's Stacy's fault because she only understands English.
Scuze, vorbesc românește, dar foarte puțin.
So we're going to talk much and that's why it's going to be in English.
Bine. And mulțumesc, dragă.
You're very welcome. Free entrance in a concert of yours?
I'll make it happen.
Okay, deal. You are both musicians and you have met on YouTube.
Right.
You posted a song, Cornel made a comment. Before we see what sort of comment that was that made you become interested in him as a musician, before that, let's see a few things about you, both of you. Because as I said, you are musicians. What's your musical activity in general? Cornel, you first.
I started with teaching music, guitar lessons, especially, and then it developed into working with more musicians, and then I ended up working with whole teams, music teams, with churches. From Cluj, Timișoara, Deva, Oroștie, abroad in Belgium or
America
this time. So I think it gradually developed.
And that's all you do, music?
That's all I do, music. And it can be done.
And what is it about Stacy that made you engage in such a huge project, a trilogy? And only this first album is a huge work,
yeah,
so why?
Exactly. Well, I think, first of all, that would be a question that she could answer better, but...
she will.
She will. Right. I guess, I don't know, somehow I've learned that she's part of the family friends, and she recorded this song she put on YouTube, and I just gave my impression on it. I said, it's nice, it's nicely made, I hear this and that through the song, which was not recorded actually, and that's where she picked up. So,
because I heard the same thing, which wasn't recorded, so I was like, he's a visionary and we're hearing the same stuff. And, oh, sorry, it's not my turn.
No, it's good.
Yes, it
it's
is
good.
Now.
I think it is now.
It is.
I'm just adding. So yeah, you're on. That's exactly
go
it.
Go ahead.
So that you've seen good. A visionary.
Yes. Yes.
Go ahead. It's good. Yeah, I think it was perfect where you
okay,
picked up.
Okay.
I was hoping you will pick it up there.
Yeah, that he
did he see something more in your project than you yourself saw, or did he see the same thing that you saw in your project?
I think he was the first person to see it for the way that I saw it, mm-hmm. which is really epic. And for years I carried it by myself and I was working on it on my own. Knowing I could never completely finish it by myself, but I was doing what I could on my own, praying for a guitarist for years. I prayed for a guitarist and I prayed that the Lord would send me someone who could play the guitar on my album, who also has a passionate heart for the Lord, a life of no compromise, and so that we could be in unity in the spirit together, and also who course was skilled on their instrument, but that would have a vision for the project. And
so you have been very specific, a guitar player and a sort of co-producer.
Yeah, actually I was only praying for a guitarist.
Ah, so you
but I
you've
got
been
much
given more.
I got more than I asked for, and the Lord knew exactly what I needed.
I'm sure you didn't see 13 months in Romania. You didn't see a lot of stuff.
No, I didn't see that was coming. The last 5 years. It's been an adventure. We met 5 years ago. So, yeah, as he mentioned, our families had been friends for a long time. His wife's parents and my parents were friends 25 years ago. I knew his wife when she was 3 years old.
Oh.
And her parents were missionaries and my parents were missionaries, and they were translators for us in Europe when I was only 11. And
so they ministered together.
Yeah, we ministered together years ago. We stayed in touch, and then the Lord kept us connected, and then he came into the picture, and my brother was a part of that and bringing him in. And it's just neat how the Lord has started weaving this and setting the stage for what's about to happen through this project, I believe.
Mm-hmm. And if your parents were with mission, mm-hmm. This generation, your generation, is with music now.
So. Yeah, and mine were also with music.
Well, her family was all music, actually.
Yeah. Oh.
It was musical mission work. We came to Europe as missionaries, but we were bringing the gospel through music and leading worship and doing meetings. And
you are also with music only, like your parents, because you teach piano and voice.
And voice, that's right. Yeah, I teach private music lessons out of my home, and I lead worship and write songs. Mm-hmm. So that also was my life in music.
And how did this idea come of a trilogy? I know you have had songs.
Yeah.
You have had written songs.
Exactly.
When did you see a trilogy coming?
Well, I knew I was supposed to record a project for many years, and the name Transcend came to me in, I think it was 2002 or 3. And the word transcend itself means to overcome, to rise above, to exceed the limits of. And when you read the scripture, the word overcomer is in the Bible a lot, in the book of Revelation especially, which speaks a lot of the end times. And my desire is to help the bride be ready for the Lord's return and to become all that she's created to be. And that is an epic story. And that's not something that you can really capture, even on 3 CDs. And even the Bible itself, it says, you know, the books couldn't contain all that would be written if we write only about the works that Jesus did while he was on the earth. So it is the greatest story ever told, and this is just a piece of it. But I originally thought I was just going to do one CD called Transcend.
So you thought it was enough?
Yeah, I thought, oh, I'll do a CD. It'll be a very important special CD that is in my heart to do, and I will do that, and that's Transcend. But
did you write the songs on that theme?
No, I've written songs all my life as an expression of things that I've gone through or something the Lord is teaching me. It's like my journaling. Some people write in prayer journals. I write songs.
Of course.
And my desire is that, of course, they would eventually be shared with people to encourage them. And so.
But you didn't know it's going to be a trilogy and
no.
On this theme.
No, I discovered that later.
That was actually Edgar looking into it and saying, hey, this goes more towards
Edgar?
That direction. Edgar.
That's my husband.
Oh,
yeah.
Another piece of this great puzzle.
Yes, another piece of the puzzle, another chess piece on the board of the Lord.
And he suggested that could be...
It could be a trilogy. Yeah.
Because there was a lot of songs coming. It's like, if you listen to how she takes like a certain topic and she'll start developing and talking on it, you'll immediately notice she can tell a lot about one small subject that I think someone will just look and say, hey, that's that and that, and I think that's it. But she can, she's very generous and creative when it comes to that. So songs just kept on coming. So then Edgar was like, hey, wait a minute.
Someone from outside observed the course of things.
To make a long story short, we had a get together at my house, my closest friends and family. We had a night where I just played a bunch of my songs.
Why?
And they voted on their favorite songs.
Oh.
And then I decided that's what I'll put on Transcend. And then my husband and I were talking about it that evening, and someone had suggested, why don't you put the songs in order, like from the darkest songs about our hardships and then ending in the glorious songs of victory. And I thought that was just brilliant, and that's what I've been wanting to do all along.
And did you think it was going to be a trilogy?
That's when Edgar said, why not make it a trilogy and have the first album be the hardships? And I started thinking about it, and immediately the Lord gave me the titles. You'll notice the transcend the trilogy. So album one is Trials and Tribulation.
Yeah.
Album two is Triumph, or excuse me, that's album three. Album two is Trust and Transformation, and album three is Triumph and Transcendence.
A big T.
Yes. So then it was a matter of then opening my originals binder. I have all of my songs typed in chord charts in my binder at home and saying, okay, this song goes on this album. This song goes here. This song goes here.
The easy part.
So the Lord knew all along where they were going to go. I didn't know
you
I was writing them for a specific album, but they fit. And I'll have some left over as well. I have future albums that I want to record, but we'll just do Transcend first.
And did you have the lyrics first? Or
every song is different.
Oh.
I think of a song as a child. Every child has their own personality, their own unique strengths or weaknesses. And sometimes I'll get words first, and then I'll just sit down and I'll start playing the melody that comes to me. Other times I'll be playing at the piano and maybe even just worshiping, and the Lord will just give me a melody and I'll stay on that. And then I start hearing words that fit what the notes are saying, and then I'll build that. Other times I'll be in a conversation or I'll go to a meeting somewhere and a message will be shared that stirs my heart. I immediately go home and just sit at my piano and I just write, and then I just put it all together and it just comes like a flood. Mm-hmm. Other songs take longer, so every song is different for me.
And do you come back to each song a lot to polish it?
Usually when I get into the writing mode, I stay on it for about a day or two and then I'm done, usually.
Done and never come back?
I come back to it
to rewrite. I don't know. I'm just asking.
It's a good question. In the studio, you rework a song to see how will it be presented with all of the instruments and the full spectrum of, you know, instruments that you can use. But the song itself, I'm a perfectionist.
And I know Cornel is too.
Yeah,
so
that's
you
another
too.
Reason why we work well together. Because not everyone works like that, and that's
it's
cool.
A wonder you
and
have
it tends to
finished.
to get you work longer.
Yeah, you have to know. You have to know when enough is enough. But
we're working on that.
Yeah.
One,
so
though.
When I,
so is this album perfect? You two perfectionists?
No.
No, because no. I think it would be the only album we'll ever make, but.
Totally. No, at a certain point, you have to say, that's good enough. This is it. And we got to get the message to the people, because that's what it's all about. It's not about having something perfect musically or anything like that. Of course, we want to do everything with excellence. There's a difference between bound by perfection and serving in excellence, and that's our heart, is just to be excellent. But with the writing, I get to a point where I know that's what the song is supposed to be. I have birthed everything that I'm supposed to birth. It's finished, it's balanced, and it's done. And then I leave it and just share it at different places as the Lord leads.
I think it's about, you see, even the Lord taught his people not to dress poorly, and you know, so everything he made is like exquisitely beautiful, and it's like richly dressed.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we're trying to see that the songs are not poorly dressed.
Yeah,
that's
so
you
overdressed
you
or underdressed.
You dressed up songs.
That's a good way to put it.
I'm helping with tailoring stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
How much?
A lot. Transcend would not be what it is without this guy, and yet he wouldn't have had anything to produce had I not written them. So I mean, it's a really good team, and he gives me a lot of space to still say what I want to say as an artist. He's sensitive to that, but in the end, I usually defer to him because I am subjective. It's my song, and
mm-hmm.
or objective, whichever one that is.
You are subjective. I mean, it's
yeah.
your
yeah,
child.
Subjective. Yeah, exact. Yes, it's my child, and he's the one that's helping me to like put it on a diet. Or feed it some more food, depending on what it needs, or dress it mm-hmm. differently. And
yeah, my principle usually working with musicians is you have to respect them because they write the music, and I would never go over the musician's decision. I will just present
identity.
It. Yeah, I will say you could do this or this or that. These are your options that I can see. And they can choose something, but if they would say, no, I don't like that, I really don't like that, then I'm not gonna go over their decision to force them into something. Because and then you get to the point where each song is different. I mean, if you hear one song of this CD and you see, you'll say everything sounds like this, it's not correct. Because some songs are like really rich and go into many musical styles, but some will be like very simple and very, they'll just tell a story like peacefully. And so you really have to look into, you don't dress every song the same way, you know.
I could only hear and see Deliver Us From Evil.
Yeah, because the others are still being worked on.
Yeah, so. And it was from a concert that you held in the States.
Right.
And it sounded to me like a rock opera. Do you disagree or agree?
Huh? That's very good. You're not the only person to have said that. That's confirmation.
So it is this.
You could call it that. A contemporary Christian musical saga.
Yeah, and you know what? This album, this trilogy actually of yours, have reminded me of The Pilgrim's Progress.
Thank you.
In music, in musical terms.
That's an honor. That's one of my favorite books of all time.
Oh.
And I only read it a few years
ago
after.
Maybe it influenced you.
Yeah, I was well into the project actually already, but reading it was confirmation of what I'm doing. And yeah, it's been a story that's been around forever. So
yeah, and
he expressed it beautifully through literature, and this is a meager attempt to express our story as believers through song. So
is it a story or an album for a Christian audience?
Mostly, yes, but it is also for people that don't know the Lord yet. There's a couple of songs on this project that could even be on secular radio, and that wasn't intentionally like, oh, I'm going to put a song so that we can get on secular radio, but...
Which one, for instance?
Take Me Home.
Mm-hmm.
Take Me Home is a song about grief, and because I lost my father in 2004 unexpectedly. Actually, both songs in the section about grief, Take Me Home and Empty, neither of them specifically mention God or the name of Jesus or any of that. It's just being honest with the pain of grief and losing someone that you love. And anyone can relate to that. All of humanity can relate to that. And really, the Lord desires that all should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. So I'm presenting this project to anyone, to him who has ears to hear, as the Lord said, and as Keith Green would say,
mm-hmm.
who is also one of my musical heroes. But I think that it's in the Lord's hands who this ultimately reaches, but it would be awesome to have a secular and Christian audience. But my story, I'm not writing for people, I'm writing for the Lord, and I'm writing for myself. And whoever listens and can appreciate that, I welcome them to be blessed by it.
I'm feeling compelled to add to what you're asking. I think it's about the journey. It's not just a journey, because, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's about the journey of becoming the bride of Christ, the journey that we have as the Lord comes and finds us in that place where we are, and he says, I'm offering you everlasting life. Now the place between A and B, it's the journey,
mm-hmm.
right? And just like any good journey, a good journey has many good stories. So I think the trilogy is about their journey with each song or group of songs, which we actually, how we ended up organizing. It's about
sections.
Certain stories. So they come together in this one thing, the journey.
On album one,
trilogy.
That was good. On album one, our themes are, it starts with the fall of man, because that's where it all began and where all the trouble started, right? So the album will begin with the listener hearing this music and this narrative about the Garden of Eden
how
we fell.
That's just awesome.
So then you end
you
and you're like,
you can hear it, right?
What comes next?
Yeah, I did, actually.
You can hear it even now. It's in your mind.
Yes, it's awesome. You're going to love it, actually.
And then it goes immediately into the section about transgression. And actually, right after that, there's a song about agenda, which is basically the darkness of this present hour. And then we have transgression, which is the sin within, our own personal struggle. And that goes into grief, the valley of the shadow of death. And then, you know, losing loved ones. And then it goes into the prodigal, So that's a call to repentance to all who have once walked in the light or been in the home of the Father and have followed the world instead, and calling them back. And then that's the first disc. There's two CDs for each album.
Yeah, right.
17 songs.
So yeah, 17 songs. So that's disc one. Disc two then will open with Deception, Religious Bondage. So that's basically having a form of godliness but denying its power, not walking in obedience to the Lord, but just being puffed up with knowledge and pride and putting rules on people but not having an intimate relationship with God, because there's a difference between religion and relationship. Now, there is religion that's good, the pure religion that's undefiled, but I mean the world religion, and people say, I'm religious, but they don't know the Lord. So that section talks about that. After Deception, we go to Persecution, which is where I have a song about the sufferings of Christ. I couldn't have a song about the trials and tribulations of this present life if I didn't at least talk about the Lord himself, because he said, because I overcome, you will overcome, but mm-hmm. also no servant is greater than his master, and he suffered, and we will too. And then after that...
And it
that,
very much seems so these days.
Yeah. It, sorry, what?
It very much seems yeah, that we are going to suffer these
more
days.
And more.
More and more. And it will, before the end, it'll get even worse. But the light will also get brighter as the darkness gets darker. It can't help but the line will get even more and more defined, because that's the essence, it's opposites. And then Tribute to the Martyrs is a song I wrote for the persecuted church.
All over the world.
Yes, all over the world from the beginning of time until the Lord's return. It was inspired by a story, a Romanian pastor's story, Richard Wurmbrand, actually.
Very much well known.
Yes, yeah. He's one of my personal heroes, and he founded Voice of the Martyrs USA, and I wrote that song after hearing one of his sermons. That's one that came to me where I was driving, I hear this message, I'm sobbing in my car, I go inside and I just write the song.
Lyrics and music?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Good.
Yes.
Nice. And what else do we have on this?
Helpless is the last song in that section. It's the song of the unborn. It's about abortion. Quite a controversial issue.
And this is how the first album ends?
No, almost.
Oh.
The last thing after that, so the children's choir sings on Helpless, actually children singing for mm-hmm. those who have no voice. Then it ends with Hosanna, cry for Messiah, because you're crying out for the Lord to come and deliver us from evil.
It's the people. The people crying.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Exactly.
Everyone is welcome in this...
Yeah.
Yes. Proud.
Yes, we've been through this whole album of all these hardships and these things that we deal with personally and then with our loved ones and then worldwide issues to, my God, we need a Savior. We are a mess. What can we do to fix this? Nothing. We need someone to come and rescue us.
Okay, this
Who's
is a good
hero?
Question for the end of
yeah.
the album.
Who will be our hero?
Points to our solution.
Yeah, who will be our Prince Charming and come and rescue us? Because mm-hmm. there's a theme of this princess, lost in a forest, and she's trying to find her way home to the castle.
Oh, that's how I understand. I understand now the photos that
yes.
I've seen.
Yeah. Yes, when you see it in the CD itself,
very
it'll make
artistic.
More sense. We're on a journey, and it's as if we're lost in a dark forest, and then we're making our way home.
Oh, then I don't need to ask you, because I was going to. How can we deal with one part of a thing that has three parts, because it's okay, we can wait for the other two, because you give us a hint, a way, a horizon to
yes.
look at.
Yes, I'll give you another hint. It's also, you'll notice the bride going from the state of darkness, and this princess that is a little bit dark and a little bit lost and confused and needing redemption and needing freedom and deliverance, to someone that's coming out into the light and into the glory mm-hmm. and the color of the Lord, into ultimate glory and the whiteness of the Lord. So you're going to see, even visually in the graphic design of the project as it continues, how that's conveyed visually of our transformation if we allow the Holy Spirit to work in our lives and to change our hearts.
And how do you see the future of this first part of your trilogy? Concerts, tours?
Yes, Lord willing.
Yeah, I think we're first gonna
Absolutely.
Look forward to complete the recordings. Actually, the mixing, we're in that phase.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord's willing, we'll bring this to the people in as many places. He will open the doors too.
I dream of having concerts in the United States with a full team, like you saw on the video for Deliver Us From Evil. I think mostly we would minister in churches, but I would love to go to secular venues as well, or just general public
because
venues.
Because it's and just a story that yeah. should be heard.
Absolutely.
Because it's beautiful, first of all, and still, first of all, true and important.
Yeah, I think some people would appreciate the music too, just even if they don't understand the story, they would appreciate the music, and then maybe in coming to hear the music, they will be intrigued by the lyrics. And that could plant seeds.
Give credit to
that,
this story.
Yeah, that lead them eventually to the Lord. That mm-hmm. would be my prayer for souls to be saved through this also.
And we should say that people can still see Deliver Us From Evil. That's all they can see and hear
at
from
this, moment,
this project at mm-hmm. this moment. But they should try so that they know what to expect from you.
There are also bits and pieces of recording moments on the YouTube channels, and mm-hmm. so they can see
yeah.
small pieces, not whole songs, but like.
And because we don't have much time left, actually almost none, I want to say that it seems that this project of yours has been a trial and a tribulation, because it cost you money, time, 13 months in Romania, and for Cornell the obligation to take in a new family member mm-hmm. because you have stayed with them.
And they've come to the
well,
States
I would
twice
say the,
also.
The joy and the honor.
That's sweet.
That's sweet. I would say it like that.
I came here.
She's family to us.
Yeah. Now, yeah.
Yeah. I've been here twice, they've been there twice. Altogether, we've lived with each other for 2 years, over the past 5 years.
And because we have talked about this album as being a journey, and it is, tell me, in the end, and that's the only thing I want from you now, after this journey, which has been musical and emotional for you, what did you gain?
I've become more of an overcomer myself. My prayer through this whole thing has been, Lord, I don't want to release a project about overcoming if I am not walking in that also. And we have experienced a lot of hardships in many different ways, but through it all, I can say that God is faithful and I've become more of an overcomer. And I'm learning to transcend. And I think that's a journey we'll be on until we shed this flesh and we're given a new body. But that's what the call is for all of us who will choose.
Yeah, I was thinking, is that a trick question? Because we have to end this would be a good question to begin with. it's very hard to say, because with this journey, you start in it with a certain, you know, confidence in, you have to get to the place where you live the life that you will tell the people
in the songs
to do so. So you have to work on yourself and your character and your, on the other side, like financially, we put everything we had in this project. They did, we did. It teaches you to give everything for the sake of the kingdom. It's not worth it to keep stuff for you here, invested. No. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It showed us that you can choose to do something in this life for your own career, for your own good and stuff. Or you can lay it all down and the Lord will pick it up and will say, okay, now I can use you. Let's
a
see
bit
what
of a
we
risk.
Can do together. Sorry?
A bit of a risk.
Yeah, well, I don't have the words for it, but it's awesome, the most amazing years, to be honest.
I want to just ask one thing, if possible, that all of those watching, can I look at the camera?
Yes, please talk to them.
sorry, I'm going to cry.
Don't, just talk.
Okay, I love Romania very much, and it has been an honor for me to be here. And I ask that whoever you guys are watching, be that in Romania or around the world, that you pray for us. You pray for this project. It really is a project for for people in this hour. And we need all the support we can get in prayers and financially. And pray that the Lord will open the doors for us to have concerts around the world. I don't want to only do concerts in the States. I want to come here to Romania. I want to travel Europe, Africa, wherever the doors will open. And that the Lord will send us volunteers and team members to help us in all areas of doing this thing, because it's a huge project, not just musically, but also business-wise, and there's so many things to it. So I ask you to become prayer partners with us in any way that the Lord would put on your heart to be a part of this. We welcome you to be a part of this journey with us.